Suppose I didn't want to use Excel. Suppose I just wanted to see my data as it was coming out and see what it looked like. Well, in addition to the serial monitor, there's also this serial plotter. And what it can do, and this blue one, that's the line that's the output in time. So of course it's rising linearly in time. And here are our sinusoidal values. So we can see exactly what's coming out of our Arduino with time as we go along. Once again, serial speed better be the same. Now, if I didn't want to have this blue line, I could go over here and I could just Command or Control slash to comment those out, run it again. So the serial plotter starting from scratch, I can just see the two sinusoids. So now that I know that this data is coming out just the way it should, I'm going to close that monitor, go over here to Jupyter Notebooks, and I'll go to My Documents. I open up that Python notebook, and a new window pops up, and it shows me what's going on here. Now, in order for that to work, I have to make sure that first I install PY Serial, and there are instructions here. And then I need to run these Jupyter Notebook cells. So if I run that one, it imported a bunch of things. I run this one, it'll tell me a list of my existing serial ports. And I've got that FD1421. I think that's the one that I was seeing for the Arduino over here. Yeah, FD1421 is what the Arduino's on. So I'd better find one that matches. I didn't have that one already, so let's make a copy. I'll comment out the previous one. And that says it's CU, Dev CU USB modem FD1421. That's the way it is on my Mac. If you're using Windows, it'll be something much shorter like COM3. So now I'll run that one and run some more of these cells. The code in this cell will go and grab 5 lines from the serial port just to see if it can, and then interpret them as numbers. This next cell is going to go and get 100 lines of data, extract the numbers into arrays, and then plot them as a graph. We'll spend more time in the active learning sessions making sure that you can use this functionality too.